he will be the chairperson. And of course, we've got Shady Shah on stage later. But allow me to first introduce Ustaz Mohammad Zahid. And then thereafter, Ustaz Mohammad Zahid will introduce Shady Shah properly. Ustaz Zahid runs an organization. My apologies. Let me first share his Islamic education background. Ustaz Zahid was actually a student of Madrasa Al-Junayn, and he graduated subsequently from.
He currently runs an organization called Islamic Learning for Muslims with Learning Disabilities. Very interesting organization. It includes producing the Quran in Braille. Secondly, he is known to be passionate for youth issues. And now, I saw this on Facebook and I think it's worth sharing. Unfortunately, I'm too old to attend because there's an age limit for this talk. It's called Rasulullah in Facebook. It's on the 12th of May, and you need to be 35 and below, so I do not qualify. But there are many of you here whom I'm sure could qualify, and inshallah you'll find value in that. You might want to look for Ministry of Salawat. It's a Facebook page that Ustaz Yazid's event is featured there. It will be on the 12th of May at Al Nahdah Mosque after Maghrib. Rasulullah in Facebook, a talk to be held by Ustaz Yazid. Okay, the advertisement is over. Let me warmly welcome Sheikh Hisham Kabbani, Chairman of the Islamic Supreme Council of America and the U.S. leader of the Naqshbandi Haqqani Sufi Order. We would also like to welcome Chairperson Ustaz Yazid on stage. Let's give them a very warm welcome.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
يا سيدي إن شاء الله سيدي. بسم الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. Let us start this beautiful event with the recitation of Surah Al-Fatiha. أنا هذه النية وكل نية صالحة الفاتحة. أعوذ بالله. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for being here today. On behalf of Simply Islam, I would like to welcome all of you in this blessed majlis. Today, we are very pleased to welcome Sheikh Mohammad Hisham Kabbani, a very special guest from the United States. I believe most of you here have known Sheikh Hisham through his visit to Singapore, but inshallah, let us give me some moment to introduce Sheikh Hisham Kabbani for our, the benefit of our new audience, inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Born in Lebanon, Sheikh Mohammad Hisham Kabbani is a world-renowned Muslim scholar, author and lecturer. He received his Islamic law, yani Sharia degree, in Damascus, Syria. He also studied deeply the subject of Islamic spirituality and the two renowned Naqshbandi spiritual guides, namely Sheikh Abdullah Al-Faiz Al-Daghestani and Sheikh Nazim Ali Al-Haqqani. He also holds a bachelor degree in chemistry from the American University of Beirut and also studied medicine in Leuven, Belgium. Sheikh Hisham Qabbani is a leader of the Naqshbandi Haqqani Sufi Order and also chairman of the Islamic Supreme Council of America, ISCA. He constantly promotes traditional and moderate Islamic views and is often engaged in inter-religious dialogue. He also advised numerous organizations, world leaders, and governments on issues regarding Islam, religious tolerance, and extremism. His literary productions, publication includes numerous books covering subjects like Islamic spirituality, Sirah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Aqidah, Sharia, and many more. Sheikh Hisham has addressed students and academics at many universities like Oxford, Harvard, Columbia, UC Berkeley, UCLA, McGill, and Georgetown. He is regularly sought after and interviewed by newspaper, television stations, and magazines for his sound views of Islam, Sharia, Sufism, and Islamic extremism. Sheikh Hisham's Qabbani vision is to spread and the peaceful and beautiful teaching of Islam. His efforts are directed at bringing the diverse spectrum of religious and spiritual paths into harmony with one and another. Inshallah, today Sheikh Hisham will grace us and share us on the topic of even though we've never met. I just want to give a quick overview, inshallah, Sheikh, on what is the agenda for today, inshallah. As you have read over on Facebook or even the pamphlet given, that today we're going to talk about Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is said in hadith, one day Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his companions, "Oh, how I yearn for my brothers." So the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, "Are we not your brothers, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?" He said that, "Indeed, you are my companions. My brothers are those who believe in me without ever seeing me." And so today, Sheikh Hisham Qabbani shall elucidate the above mentioned prophetic tradition and will also discuss the requirements to be considered as the Prophet ﷺ's brothers. With that, I ask you, ladies and gentlemen, to give your full attention to our speaker's lecture and let help me in welcoming Sayyidina Sheikh Hisham Qabbani to the podium. Sayyidina Sheikh Hisham, falyatafaddal mashkura.
Shukran. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله الذي هدانا للإسلام وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله الذي جعلنا وشرفنا بأن نكون من أمة الحبيب المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. والحمد لله الذي جعل الحبيب المصطفى شفيعا للمسلمين وشفيعا للمؤمنين وشفيعا لكل من قال لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. وهذا لا يعني أنه ليس شفيعا للآخرين. Oh Muslim brothers and sisters, we thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى that made us followers of Prophet سيدنا محمد عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. I would like to thank Simply Islam for this event, and I would like to thank them always, because every time they do an event, it is a successful event, and they need your support and they need your prayers. And let me say also, they need your help. So help them, Allah helps you. I don't know from where Muhammad Nasir of Simply Islam, every time he surprised me with a title to speak about. And now he's coming up with the title we never thought we met. That title is a very technical Islamic principle, and we have to be aware of many things in order to understand it. And I'm hope that with my very little, might be not lower than, less than a drop of knowledge, I'm not claiming I am anything, or I am a scholar, or I am, no, I am at the door by the shoes. It's better to be by the door, not to be on the podium. Because on the podium you be responsible. By the door you are not responsible. You can take your shoes and run away even. But here, you cannot take your shoes, you have to take them off. The hadith that he just mentioned, it says, عن ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنه وارضاه. This riwayah is the wider riwayah, is the more comprehensive riwayah than the one that is mentioned in the synopsis of this title. أنه قال, ابن عباس said, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, that Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one day said to his people who are sitting with him, لجلسائه, أي الناس أعجب إيمانا, which are the people who are of the best iman, the iman that make me astonished, make me stunned. Prophet is saying like that. He's asking his Sahaba, who are these people? Do you hear about them? Or you can figure who are these people? And they looked and they were thinking. And they said, who can be the best of iman? And they said, angels that always are under Allah's order in anything. There must be angels. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, قال وكيف لا تؤمن الملائكة والأمر فوقهم يرونه. How the malaik, the angels, are not going to have iman, strong iman, when they are in the divine presence and they are seeing what they are seeing. So of course the angels are the best of iman. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, they are not of the best iman. They have iman, but there are other of the best iman, because angels seeing what they are doing, they are in the divine presence. Then Sahaba were thinking and they said, Ya Rasulullah, قالوا الأنبياء. If not angels, then prophets. And Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وكيف لا يؤمن الأنبياء والأمر ينزل عليهم غدوة وعشية. How prophets are not going to believe, to have iman, when Allah is revealing to them morning and evening. They are hearing Allah's revelation through Jibreel alayhi salam, bringing them the message. Or Sayyidina Musa talking directly, Kareemullah. How they are not going to believe? And they are being revealed to them. فَقَالُوا Then Sahaba look at Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and what do you think they said? They said, okay, if not angels, not prophets, then us. Who else there is left? Us. Because we are following you. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وكيف لا تؤمنون. How you say, how you dare to say us? How you cannot have iman? وأنتم ترون من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما ترون. And you are in between Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and you are seeing what he is bringing to you. How you must not have iman? You are the best of iman. No, there are other that they are best of iman. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and he said أعجب الناس إيمانا. The best of iman. The most people that they have iman. قوم يأتون بعدي من بعدي يؤمنون بي ولم يروني. Group of people that will come after me, means after you or Sahaba also, they believe in me and they didn't see me. هؤلاء أخواني. They are my brothers. You are those people. You are the brothers of Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he mentioned you in front of his Sahaba, that are coming people who never saw me, accepted me. They are my brothers. They are so close to me. That's how Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is looking at us. And they said in another hadith that they يؤمنون بي ولم يروني. They believe in me and they didn't see me. And then one day, in another hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sahaba were seeing him, he has so much emotions and love. And he said to the Sahaba, متى ألقى أحبابي? When I am going to meet my lovers? فقال بعض الصحابة, the Sahaba, they said, are we not your brother, your lovers? He said, no, you are my companions. ولكن أحبابي, my lovers, are a group of people, they come after me, they believe in me, and they did not see me. I am so in love to see them. I want to see them. Here, we have to be very careful in the Arabic word. He said, Aina ahbabi? Where are my lovers? Can you love someone without seeing him? Huh? No. You cannot love someone without seeing her or him. Today you marry like before, covered top to bottom, and they say this is your wife. No, you want to see at least the face. It's sunnah. So can you love someone without seeing? No. What do you think about Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He knew his ummah or not? That is the question. He knew us or he did not know us? When he is asking to see the people whom he loves most, and he said they are my brothers. Brothers don't see each other. Companion, you might be a companion, you might not be a companion. Might be he sees you, he might not see you. But a brother coming from mother and father, they have to be knowing each other. So did Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew them? This is the question. Did he know us? It's very simple. Before we go into the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I will ask a question. Do you know a person called Ahmad Tijani?
No.
Yes. No, say no. Say no. No. You go to Google, you check a little bit, Ahmad Tijani, you found this gentleman, this sheikh. Correct or not? You go to Facebook, you see him and you see hundreds behind him, his fans. How Google can know and Prophet cannot know? It's impossible. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah gave him heavenly technology. Google, what they have. Facebook, your Facebook, what they have. They have all garbage. Every garbage you want to find in the world that they throw in the trash, you find in Google's or Facebook or Twitter or I don't know what. And we say Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam doesn't know, he is a human being, he is like us. Okay, what is being mentioned in the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Jabir, which is narrated in Musannaf Abdul Razzaq, and it is a very famous Musannaf Sahih that mentioned many volumes, and he mentioned many ahadith, and the whole ummah scholars after they took from him that hadith. It's mentioned in the Al-Mawahib Al-Kastalani. Rawahu Abdul Razzaq bi sanadihi an Jabir ibn Abdullah. He said, قال قلت يا رسول الله بأبي أنت وأمي أخبرني عن أول شيء خلقه الله تعالى قبل الأشياء. I give you يا محمد, Jabir is saying, يا محمد, I sacrifice myself, my father, my mother, tell me what Allah has created first. What Allah created first? Anyone knows? They say Big Bang. A Big Bang has an interpretation, has meaning in this hadith also. فقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم إن الله تعالى خلق قبل الأشياء نور نبيه صلى الله عليه وسلم. He created the light of his prophet before creating anything. The light of prophet was created. From where the light can be created? Some scholars, they say that the light of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was created, and that's why I told you that topic is very technical. Don't get bored. Blame him. Where is he? But it's very good to know. Either from Nurillah, Allah huwa An-Nur, one of his attributes, beautiful names, An-Nur. So if we put shut the down the Nur, the light here now, can anyone see anyone?
No sir.
No sir. Why Ahmad Tijani all the time has to respond and no one else, everyone is quiet? Everything we will not see, even now the microphone system was not working even because there is no energy, there is no light, Nur, in it. So if there is no light, you cannot see anything. So when the light comes, you know everything and you see everything. So Allah created Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qabla al-ashya, before anything to be created. فجعل ذاك النور يدور بالقدرة حيث يشاء. And that nur that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Prophet from, and the evidence Allah has said in Holy Quran, and might be something that might be a controversial issue to some scholars, because they might explain it in their ways, but Quran carries secrets. Every ayah can carry millions of meanings. So don't object. Allah said in Holy Quran, Inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nazira. We have sent you witness. Wa mubashiran, giving good tidings, and wa nazira, and warning people. We take the first part only. Inna arsalnaka shahidan. He didn't say Inna arsalnaka shahida for 1,500 years of age. He didn't limit it with an age time. He said Inna arsalnaka shahidan. We send you a witness. Witness means we are making you, Ya Muhammad, to know every details that of my creation that I have created from my light, to be witness on them from day one until day of judgment. So what Allah created first? Created the Nur of Muhammad to be witness on Allah's creation. Then after Allah created the light of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He put that light, and that light begin in a, we cannot explain in what, but He said فَجَعَلَ ذَلِكَ النُّورِ يَدُورُ بِالْقُدْرَةِ حَيْثُ يَشَاءُ. That nur begin to turn around. يدور, يدور in Arabic, to turn. Is not turning, Professor?
Yes, it's correct. It's
why Sheikh Ahmad Tijani has to go? It's turning.
Yes, sir.
It's turning and turning and turning, and when something is turning and turning and turning fast enough that in a speed of the speed of light, what will happen? Energy will produce. Now science. So energy was produced, and when energy is produced, everything is energy. If we go back to science, you find everything on Earth is energy. Did anyone say how Earth is turning around its axle? With what? Non-stopping?
It's solar energy.
It's energy. He said, وَلَمْ يَكُمْ فِي ذَلِكَ الْوَقْتِ لَوْحٌ وَلَا قَلَمْ وَلَا جَنَّ وَلَا نَارٌ وَلَا مَلَكٌ وَلَا سِيَّمَ وَلَا سَمَاءٌ وَلَا أَرْضٌ وَلَا شَمْسٌ وَلَا قَمَرٌ وَلَا جِنِّي وَلَا إِنْسِي. There was no one being created from that time. Not the preserved tablet, not the pen, not paradise, not hellfire, not angels, not heavens, not earth, not sun, not moon, not a jinn, not an ins. Means before everyone being created, the light of Prophet ﷺ was created. فَلَمَّا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَخْلُقَ الْخَلْقِ قَسَّمَ ذَاكَ النُّورِ إِلَىٰ أَرْبَعَةِ أَقْسَامِ. When Allah wanted to create creation, He divided that light into four different divisions. There is a hadith says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 2000 years before Adam alayhi salam. There is another hadith says that Allah created the light of Muhammad before 14,000 years from the creation of Adam alayhi salam. Means Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has seen the creation of a human being through Adam alayhi salam, where he said, and that's where it makes meaning to scholars, that he said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كُنْتُ نَبِيًّا وَآدَمُ بَيْنَ الرُّوحِ وَالْجَسَدِ. I was a prophet and Adam between soul and spirit, and between soul and spirit and body. And he said, also the second hadith, كُنْتُ نَبِيًّا وَآدَمُ بَيْنَ الْمَاءِ وَالطِّينِ. I was a prophet and Adam between water and clay and mud. So means Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah, when He say, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ, we have raised your level. Dhikrak is not your only name, but we raised you, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your level that no one can understand, no one will know. We raised you for everyone to be created after you, to know you and to point on you. That's why He said to angels, make sajda. Tell to angels, make salawat on Prophet. Since when? إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. Allah and His angels are making salawat on Prophet. Since when? Anyone knows? No. Tab, okay. Did Allah said to them, now stop making salawat?
No.
Means all angels that Allah created before and created every moment and until creation will never end, because Allah Al-Khaliq and His creation never end. Even after day of judgment, Allah knows what will be kind of creations and what kind of angels will be created. Never ends. So since never ends, they are making salawat on Prophet without seeing Prophet or with seeing Prophet. Of course, you cannot make salawat without seeing someone there. To whom you are addressing your salawat? Allah brought His beloved one Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Kaaba Qawsaini aw Adna for us to know that Prophet can go there. But for angels, they already know through that hadith that Allah created him first. So he made that light into four parts. فخلق من الجزء الأول القلم. From the first he created the pen to write. And ordered the pen to write لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. ومن الثاني اللوح. From the second division he created the preserved tablet. ومن الثالث العرش. And from the third light he created the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah created. ثم قسم الجزء الرابع إلى أربعة أقسام. Then he divided the last part into four parts also. And he created, and I will shorten it. He created the kursi. He created, and then the second he created angels. And then the last one he divided it into four different parts. He created from the beginning as-samawat, وَمِنَ الثَّانِي الْأَرْضِينَ, and the second the earth, and the third is Jannah, and the fourth is Nar. Then what is left, he divided it into four different parts, where this is where important for us. فَخَلَقَ مِنَ الْأَوَّلِ نُورَ أَبْصَارِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. From the first, he created the light of believers in their foreheads. When Adam alayhi salam disobeyed and Allah sent him on earth, he struck his back. When he struck his back, all the his grandchildren begin to appear, and on every one there was لما خلق الله عز وجل آدم مسح على ظهره فخرج منه كل أبنائه. All his children came from him. They were coming down. And Sayyidina Adam looked at them and he said, Ya Rabbi, who are these? He said, these are your children. And he put nur in the light in their forehead, as this hadith mentioned, that he put nurul mu'mineen in their forehead. He said, Ya Rabbi, what is that? He said, this is the light that you can know them with. That's why Allah ordered angels to make sajda to Adam, sajda ihtiram, bowing to Adam, not sajda ibadah, but sajda respect, because of the light of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the forehead of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. So everyone who came from Sayyidina Adam, since Sayyidina Adam carried the light of Muhammad in his forehead and the angels making sajda for that light, everyone has a trace of that light in his forehead. Be happy, you have a trace of that light. That's what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioning. And he saw one, and I will mention that hadith because very important, many people don't go through it. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه مرفوعا بسند حسن رواه البيهقي وابن إسحاق. لما خلق الله آدم خير لآدم بنيه فجعل يرى فضائل بعضهم بعض. When Allah created Adam, he made Adam to see his grandchildren, and he began to say some better than the others. فرآني, and Prophet is saying, he saw me نورا ساطعا. He saw me a light, very strong light. فقال يا رب من هذا, who is that one, oh Allah, who is that one? قال هذا ابنك, this is your son أحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, هو الأول والآخر وهو أول شافع يا آدم. رواه البيهقي بسند حسن. So he is the first, he is the last. He is the one who make intercession, And no one can do intercession except him unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give other prophets intercession. But we know that all prophets and their nations, they come to Prophet to ask intercession in the Day of Judgment. So here we see that Adam alayhi salam was able to see Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after him, since between Adam and Sayyidina Muhammad there is 7,000 years. So 7,000 years after, in the future, he was seeing Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Instead, Sayyidina Muhammad was seeing Adam because he was seeing what is before, what is after. Look the difference between a prophet and a prophet. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah gave him what he did not give anyone. Then he created from the second part of that light, قلوبهم وهي المعرفة بالله. He gave prophets, gave mu'mineen their hearts and the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Gave from the third, أنسهم, to be familiar, to be good, to be happy. And وكلمة التوحيد, to be happy with كلمة التوحيد لا إله إلا الله Muhammadun Rasulullah. So Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard. Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard. Allah is the light of heavens and earth. It's good. But scholar they say, Laysa kamithlihi shay. There is nothing resemble him. Then how the ayah comes here and say Allah Nuru Samawati wal Ard, where you cannot compare Allah to anything? So means that verse of Holy Quran implies whom? It implies Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalus salatu wassalam. It doesn't imply Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ. He is unknown, he is known through his beautiful names and attributes. He is a Nur, but he is not Nur. He is An-Nur, the absolute light. But he is not Nur, means a light. So the ayah says, اللَّهُ نُورُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Then he says in another place, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ. Nothing can example be like him. So means that Nur, that been example, the light of heaven and earth, is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللَّهُ نُورُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. So we explain that. مَثَلُ نُورِهِ, the example of his light, كمشكات فيها مصباح. How ليس لك مثله شيء. And here we say the example of his nur is like a bundle of lamps of light. Means the bundle, الله نور السماوات والأرض, مثل نوره, the example of his nur, we cannot give an example of for anything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah has nothing, laysa kamithlihi shay'un, nothing can be compared to him. مثل نوره كمشكات فيها مصباح المصباح في زجاجة. The example of his light means the reality of the light that created creation from is Muhammadur Rasulullah. Is that bundle, that lamp is on it. مثل نوره كمشكات فيها مصباح. So المصباح في زجاجة. المصباح, that سراج منيرة, that illuminated سراج مصباح, what you call it in English, مصباح, candle,
a lamp.
That lamp is محمد رسول الله. And with that light, he was able to see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is creating. So we cannot say, even though we have never met. No, we have met. أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَى. We have met with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He asked us, not in a meeting form to form, حَاشَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ, but in a heavenly, divinely, holy presence. We were there and we've been asked, am I not your Lord? And Allah, and we said, yes, you are our Lord. And when we say you are our Lord, for sure, رَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ, Allah put His name with the name of Prophet. Everyone will see Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with them, because his Prophet is not going to be outside humanity. So we met, yes, we met, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mushtaqun lakum. He is missing you. You are here. Don't say no. He is missing every mu'min who believed in him and didn't see him. He is his brother or his sister. You are his brothers and you are his sisters. He is missing you, because this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is describing his beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In another hadith, he said, ana min Allah wal mu'minuna minni. I am from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and mu'min are from me. Who mentioned that description? Is Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani in his book Sirr al Asrar. He said, khalaqtu Muhammadan awwalan min nuri wajhi. I have created Muhammad first from the light of my face. And he confirmed hadith of Jabir by saying, awwal ma khalaq Allah ruhi. And Sayyidina Abu Qadir Jilani said, added, wa awwal ma khalaq Allah nuri, wa awwal ma khalaq Allah al-qalam, wa awwal ma khalaq Allah al-aql. All of them are description of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ar-ruh, description of the ruh of Prophet. Al-nur, description of the light of Prophet. Al-qalam, description of the knowledge of Prophet. And al-aql, description of the intelligence of Prophet. Abdul Qadir Jilani mentioned that in his book. He said, فالروح المحمدية خلاصة الأكوان وأول الكائنات. He said, the light of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, الروح المحمدية أو الروح المحمدي, the Muhammadan light is this cream of all universes, and it is the beginning of creation. وَأَصْلُهَا كَمَا قَالَ النَّبِيُّ, and the beginning of it, the origin of it, is what said in the hadith, أَنَا مِنَ اللَّهِ, I am from Allah. Why? Because he said, I am from his light. وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ مِنِّي, and the believers are from me. I can continue, Sheikh. I will never finish. So what you, huh?
Take your time, sir.
Because you are going to take 3 hours after me. It is said in Surah Lut, أَلَيْسَ الصُّبْحُ بِقَرِيبِ يَا مُوسَى. When Musa was asking, Ya Rabbi, destroy for me Fir'aun, destroyed for me Fir'aun. He is a tyrant. Allah said, it's not early morning, is soon. Is not the light of dawn near? Ka'b al-Ahbar said, this entire verse is for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not for Musa alayhi salam. Refer to Muhammad. It is a metaphor of the light of Muhammad, the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is the niche, the lamp, is the prophethood, the class is his heart, the blessed tree is the revelation, and the angels who brought it, the oil are the proofs and evidence which contain the revelation. Alaysa subhu bikari? Is the dawn near? Yes, the dawn is coming near. Muhammad is coming. Ya Musa, don't be worried. He is coming. He is with you. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. They say in the commentary or translation, as they call it, that be known that Muhammad is among you. Of course we know Muhammad is among the Ummah. But that verse doesn't mean like that. وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ. Must be known to you that Muhammad is in you. His light, the trace of his light in your forehead is in you. So it cannot be far. Everyone, if he looks well into his heart, he will find the light of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Ismail al-Bukhari, never he wrote a hadith without confirming that hadith with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is a very well established principle that Imam Bukhari used to, when he categorized a hadith in chapters, he make istikhara sleep and he see Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling him, put that hadith in this chapter, that hadith in this chapter, that hadith in this chapter. Ru'yatun Nabi in the dream, to see Prophet in the dream, is acceptable. So if we can see Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the dream, angels cannot see Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One day Allah ordered them to make sajda to Adam, and his light is in his forehead. I ask you a question, this which is too much, I am stunned with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ. Correct? That Allah ordered angels to make sajda to Adam, and they made sajda except Iblis. A question here. Can you find for me one ayah in Holy Quran say to angels, raise your heads? So what angels are doing now? They are in sajda. They are in sajda for the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised him to Kaaba Kausaini aw Adna. Is that one that Allah ordered angels to make sajda? Sajda to ihtiram, sajda of respect. And Allah never told them to raise their heads back. You cannot find one ayah in Holy Quran or one hadith that say, oh my angels, now raise your head. You cannot find. They cannot know that they are there in the presence, in that presence that Allah wants them to know about Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, rafa'ana laka dhikrak. They are continuously in sajda. Oh Muslims, greatness of Sayyidina Muhammad, if you want to go through that, is unbelievable. You cannot understand it. It's beyond our mind. He mentioned one hadith that I am in love with my brothers. They are ikhwani, they are my brothers, those who are coming in the last days, in after me, and they didn't see me. What do you think about the angels who make sajda and they didn't raise their heads down? What do you have to do with them? They are tired? Or not tired? Subhanallah. So our duty is what? Our duty is constantly to make salawat on Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I will mention to you this. I'm sorry, but this is min kalam Sayyidi Abdul Aziz al-Dabbagh. You came across his books, is not? In Syria. He said عن عبد العزيز بن مسعود الدباغ رضي الله عنه كان لي مريدا وكنت أحبه حبا شديدا. I had a murid, a student. Many of those who are here might be there, they have teachers, they have guides guiding them or scholars. He said, I have one student that I love him so much. فكنت ذات يوم أعظم له أمر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. One day I was mentioning the greatness too much about Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And I said لولا نور سيدنا محمد ما ظهر سر من أسرار الكون. If not the light of سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, not one secret of the secrets of this universe would have appeared. How he went to Kaaba Qawsain Awadna, passed through this universe without a shuttle, space shuttle. He went with his buddy, went to Kaaba Qawsain Awadna, came back, and his mattress warm. Allahu Akbar. What kind? How they say Muhammadun Basharun? وليس كالبشر بل هو ياقوتة والناس كالحجر. Muhammad is not a human, is bashar, is a human being, but not like us. He is a gem and everyone else is a stone, pebble. There is big difference between pebble and a gem. A gem, you put it on your head. A pebble, you throw it. He said, لولا نور النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, if not for the light of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, nothing would have appeared from the secret of this universe. فلولا هو ما تفجرت عين من عيون من العيون ولا جرى نهر من الأنهار. If not for him, not even a spring would have come, not even a river would have flowed. وإنه نوره يا ولدي يفوح في الربيع حتى تثمر ببركته الأرض. When we mention, because of him, every spring, when you mention his name, and every spring, fall, spring, summer, every spring comes from that light of Nur Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a smell that make all the fruits on earth come to be fruitful. The trees, the crops will come out. يا ولدي إن أقل الناس إيمانا من يرى إيمانه على ذاته مثل الجبل. The one who is the lowest of iman is the one who think he has iman. And he thinks that he is so mu'min, he is so pious, he is so sincere, and he is carrying his iman like a mountain carrying on him, on his back. And I will cut it down until I come to this. قال يا سيدي قدمت عليك جاه النبي. He was giving an oath in the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, for the sake of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, tell me the secret. That you, how you know these things? Because the Sheikh Abdul Aziz al-Dabbagh got into a trance state that he didn't feel himself anymore. he feeling the presence of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in front of him. Anyone can say no? No. Ask, there are many people here that they saw Prophet in the dream. Yes or not? They are afraid to say yes.
Yes, sir.
They feel shy. But yes, many.
Yes, sir.
And they will have goosebumps.
Yes.
Goosebumps when they wake up. Means they have that presence still with them from that dream.
That is true.
That's true. So he said he saw his sheikh went into that trance and goosebumps on his hand and on his arms. He said, "I, for the sake of Prophet, teach me that secret." He said, I said to him, "Please don't ask me this. You don't need to know the secret." He insisted. Out of my love to him, I gave him the secret. And the secret is a combination, like, I don't say like, but it's, we have to give some scientific example. It's like you take an ATM card and you put in a machine, and you have a code. There is a code from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, holy words. You can put them together and Allah will open for your eyes. And there are many ahadith on that issue. فَلَمَّا سَمِعَ مِنِّي سِرَّ هَذَا السِّرَّ ذَهَبَ وَجَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ جَمَعَ. When he heard about that secret from me, he went and he began to collect people around him, because with that secret, people will come. So they begin to come, and he's speaking from that secret. It's a very high level secret. So people decided that this became beyond أصبح عقل غائب, lost his mind. They think that he lost his mind. They killed him like they killed Muhyiddin ibn Arabi and they killed the others. If we want to go into these spiritual deep knowledge that we learned and we understood from our teachers and from great scholars of Islam on the purification of the self and what will happen to you and to us, people might not be able to understand it. So we'll stop here, and we can say it's enough. But I like to mention here one thing. He said there are group of people يذكرون اسم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم every day. والمراد باسم النبي الاسم العالي. This is in جوهرة الكمال والصلاة على النبي باسم العالي. It's very famous in North Africa. والاسم العالي هو اسم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, means the highest level of names. So anyone who makes salawat mentioning the name, the highest name of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah will open for him what he opened for his ala inna awliya Allahi la khawfun alayhim wa lahum yahzanun. Allah will open for him as he opened for his awliya, for his saints. May Allah forgive us, and that will not finish. Still there is Mawlana Sheikh Ahmed Tijani going to speak 5 hours. So we have to prepare ourselves. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you, sir.